Hello guys, Apple Times here, welcome to a new video, and today we're gonna see the best features of iOS 17. Okay, so in the very minute that this video is being released, Apple has released iOS 17 to the public, as well as watchOS 10, tvOS 17, HomePodOS 17, and iPadOS 17. And yeah, in this video, we're gonna go through all of the features that I think are the best ones from iOS 17. Now, of course, there's hundreds of new features in iOS 17, and Apple highlights what they think are the most interesting or the most important, but I have a different opinion. There's some features that I think are very underrated, very niche, or like weren't necessarily talked about in the keynote, some were, some weren't, but in general, I think these are my top 7 features in iOS 17. So without further ado, let's go see them. Okay, so first of all is checking for iMessage. So this is a very good feature, you know, when you meet a friend and you're like, oh, let me know when you arrive home. And then they forget and everything. Well, this is exactly for that. So in iMessage, you'll be able to start a check-in with a friend, and it will let you, will let them know when you arrive home, if you have any problem, if you're delayed or everything. So this is very good. So when you first want to use it, you'll get prompted with this screen, and then you can configure it and you can select whether you want to only show some data to them or everything, like your full path and everything. And then this is when you will notify the people. So for example, notify them when your iPhone is offline, if you're delayed, and then if you're delayed, you will get a message. And if you don't respond after a few minutes, I think it's 15 minutes, then they'll notify the person, then when you arrive at your destination and everything. So to start it, we just go to iMessage, of course, then go to More and Check-in, and this little thing will load. And once it loads, you can go edit, and you can say when you want the check-in to finish. So you can select some time, like a timer will start, you can say 1 hour, 2 hours, whatever it will take you to get home, or you can automatically set it to when you arrive at a destination. So this is very good. This check-in data when you that you see here is what we just saw in the initial setup, but it can be changed in settings. And then, yeah, you can set the timer. So you can say done, and then send it. And then, yeah, your friend will receive notifications, like if your iPhone gets turned off, they will receive the last location, if you turn, you take your Apple Watch off, everything. So I think this is a very good feature for, especially for more dangerous places and everything. And I think it's very good to have. Another cool thing is that if you go to your lock screen, you will see the check-in here, and it says you'll be prompted at this time, which is when I set it to finish. And if after that time I don't reply in 15 minutes, it will send an alert to my emergency contacts and, well, to the person that I send the check-in to. The next up is voicemail for FaceTime. And that is exactly what it sounds like. Voicemail for FaceTime. So of course, if you do a FaceTime call and the recipient doesn't pick up, oh, hello there,
General Kenobi,
you see, then you'll have the option to record a video. And in that video I can say, hey, please pick up, I have something super exciting to show you. Please call me as soon as possible. And you can replay the video, record it again if anything, or send it to them. So that's pretty cool thing actually, because sometimes when you call FaceTime, it's because you have something to show the other person, and if they don't pick up, you're like, god damn it. But yeah, this is great. Now you can show them. Next up is widgets. And there's a very small change with widgets in iOS 17, but I think it's at the same time, it's a very big one. And that is that widgets can now be interacted with. So if you remember from iOS 16, which is here at the left, when you touch a widget, it will just take you to the app, which sucks. But now you can actually interact with them. So this opens new possibilities for existing widgets, and also as well as new widgets. So for example, we have the music widget, which has been updated as you just saw. And if we just have the option to hit play from here, and then it will change with the color of the album art. We can pause it as well. And then we have some other new widgets, such as the HomeKit widget. So this way we can control all of our accessories from here, which is actually very, very handy. So I can just turn on a light from here and turn it off. It's super, super handy. So this alone, this is just a couple of stock apps, but I can't wait to see what developers do with this feature. And speaking of widgets, all this of the interactive widgets and everything was probably done in the first place for the standby mode. And standby mode is another really cool feature. So when you place your phone charging on a MagSafe stand horizontally, like this, you will get this. So this is standby mode, and you can have two different widgets showing at the same time. Of like, this is the calendar, this is of course the clock, this is reminders, this is music. You can of course interact with the widgets here. So if I unlock my phone, yeah, you can see now I'm playing music, now I'm seeing all this. And yeah, this is very cool. So I can get rid of this, of course, control playback, control if I want to play somewhere else. And kind of like in the Apple Watch, this is kind of its own app. So if you go there and you start scrolling through other widgets, you will see here the little three dots, and if you tap them, it will get you back to the music. Then you can also customize all this. So kind of just like the widgets in the home screen, you have everything here, and you can customize whether you want to see, I don't know, the podcast widget and all that. And also third-party apps can also create widgets for this. So for example, you will see that I already have one app that has already been updated, which is FotMov for following football, where you can see all this and you can add the widget. So I just added it here, I will say done, and I can see the next game of my team. Also, of course, I can control HomeKit accessories from here. All in the meanwhile, I'm listening to music and playing it, I don't know, in my HomePod. Now, this will work every time that my phone is charging on MagSafe and horizontally, so it doesn't have to be a special MagSafe stand. Like as you said, as you see, I have here just the MagSafe battery on this. And it also works, of course, with the MagSafe Duo, with the regular MagSafe cable, everything. And what's super cool also is that you can have different views for different MagSafe chargers. So for example, say you have one at work and then one at home, you can have the different views for both. So maybe in the work one you have the calendar with all your events and everything, and in the home you have just pictures of your family. So that's actually very smart. Next is keyboard autocorrect. And this is actually very good. So do you remember the autocorrect before, where it would, if you were typing something and the autocorrect thought you wanted, you meant something else, it would just change it and just, yeah, you would press space, it would change it, then you would erase to change it back, and then it would change it again. That was super annoying. Now it's actually different and it works really good. Now I only found it works in English for now. I'm sure it will be added to more languages in due time. So if I type in something, you will see how I get prompted this, and like my cursor is here, but it just shows the K, so it auto-completes the word, and then if I hit space, what it will do is complete it for me. If I don't hit space, I can just continue typing. So that's actually very good. As I said, I only found it works in English, not in Spanish, for example, but the good thing is, it actually detects when I'm typing in English, because I don't change the keyboard or anything, I just type in both languages with the same keyboard. But it detects when I'm typing in English and jumps in to complete my words. So that is a very good one, and as I said, I'm sure it will come to Spanish and many more languages soon. Next up is contact poster. Now, this is actually a pretty cool feature. So you can see this is my own contact of myself, and you can go to contact photo and poster, and you can select your own contact photo and poster. And you will say, okay, what good does this make for me? Well, the cool thing is that people you call on an iPhone will see this, regardless of whether they're not your contacts. And this is pretty cool, because like you can select what contact photo people have of you. Furthermore, you can also tap two iPhones together to share your contact poster with them. And not only will you share the photo, but you can also share your contact, such as your phone number, your email, your birthday, and you can select what information you want to share with them at that moment. So that is pretty cool. Now, when you first go into contacts with iOS 17, you will get prompted to create your contact poster, and then you can select, as you can see, this is my contact poster. That's what I see in contacts. That's what people will see in contacts as well. And this is my contact photo. So the contact photo actually does not need to be the same as your contact poster. I just made it like that. But you can have two different photos of yourself. One for the contact picture that will show in round, and then one for the contact poster. And last but definitely not least is weather. Now, weather is actually something that I barely saw talked about in Apple's website or in the keynote, but it actually has so many very, very nice new features. So to begin with, you have the hourly precipitation for the next 10 days. So you used to have it only for the next 24 hours, and now you have it for the next 10 days. So you can see I'm scrolling through the days here, and I still see my hourly precipitation here. Now this is Sydney, and it's apparently not gonna rain a lot in Sydney this week. Then you might have also realized that you can see the weather from yesterday. So if I click here on the hourly, you can go to yesterday and you can see all the information on yesterday's weather. So that's super cool to see how things have changed. You would say like, oh, it seems hotter today than yesterday. Actually, let me have a look. Is it actually hotter? So that's very good. It's a very silly feature, but it's very good to have it. Then we have a brand new wind map. And this is actually super cool and super mesmerizing to see. You get the direction of the winds, you can see if there's a cyclone forming or whatever. But it's super cool and super mesmerizing. You can of course zoom in and it will load like more localized. And that's like super, super cool. And very helpful as well. I live in the coast and it's always very important to know the wind. Also by the wind, if you've ever watched the weather forecast, you know that by the wind, you can predict like new storms or whether it's going to be hot or cold or whatever. And yeah, you can definitely see it here. So this is super cool, the new maps where you used to get precipitation, temperature, air quality, etc. You now get the wind as well. Then we have moon information. And this is actually super cool because we have a lot of new information about the moon. So we have the moon rise time, the moon set time, the time till the next full moon, the distance that the moon is at, everything. We also get a moon calendar, which is super cool. So you can see on the 15th, it will be full moon. And it tells you here, new moon, full moon, everything. And then you can go see every day how it will change. And you get that super cool graphic. So this is super cool, especially I like taking pictures of, like doing astrophotography. And the moon is always important. And now we have all the moon information in here. So this is super, super cool. And last, but definitely not least, again, is the averages. So now we can see the averages. And this will tell you the average temperature and precipitation for any time of the year in the city you select. So for example, this is Sydney, and we can see that this is the current line for the temperature. So today's high will be 31, which is actually crazy because spring just started there. And what you can see here, this path here at the bottom, this is the average that of what it's usually like at this time of the year. So this is super cool, and you can see like all the average for every month, which is great. Like if you're planning a trip or something, it will be great to know. And then you can do the same for precipitation. So you can see it's only rained this much in the last 30 days, and this is where it usually rains or snows, depends on the place and the time. And then you can see historically all the precipitation. So you can see that, of course, in July, August, September, it's less rainy. And actually, probably in January and February and March, it's the most rainy. So again, this is a very useful feature, especially if you're planning a trip. Okay, so as you saw, there's plenty of very useful iOS 17 features that Apple didn't really talk about in the keynote that are very good and that you will use in your day-to-day. Because yeah, actually I've noticed with iOS 17 most of the features that they talked about in the keynote are actually some that you will just use on your day-to-day, I guess. At least most of the people, like yeah, sharing your contact with people, yeah, it's not something you'll do day-to-day. AirDrop, maybe, but yeah. I think these are the most useful features, the most, yeah, the ones that you use the most, and personally the ones I like the most. Maybe you have a different opinion. If you do, please leave me down below in the comment. Let me know which feature you love about iOS 17 that I didn't mention on the video, or maybe you agree with me and your favorite feature was in this video. If so, let me know as well. Also, for the first time, Apple has actually released a document that's like a 17-page long document with very tiny print with all the new features. I will link it down below in the comments so you can have a look for yourself and see all of the new features of iOS 17. But yeah, thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any questions about any of these features, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do my best to answer. Of course, I'm no expert, but yeah, if I can help, I'm happy to do so. Also, thumbs up if you like the video and subscribe if you like Apple content in general, because that's exactly what I post. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.